25 years, that's how long Paul Mesner and his puppets have been a part of the Kansas City art scene. In fact, old favorites like Anansi the Spider, Rapunzel, and Wiley and the Hairy Man are now playing to a whole new generation of Metro youngsters. But Paul's act also spends a lot of time on the road and on some projects that might surprise you, as Randy Mason discovers in this installment of our Perform Arts series in conjunction with KC Studio Magazine.
Ain't nothing but a hound dog crying all the time.
A kiss on the hand, maybe. Quite continental, but diamonds are a girl's best friend.
I primarily think of myself as a storyteller, and I use puppets as my actors. It's a marvelous separation because you're looking up at what you are doing, and then you also can think for this character coming in, and you can do the correct reaction with this character.
Foxy Loxy, Foxy Loxy.
And that's where it gets very pleasing because it's one brain in charge of both of these actors.
In other words, puppeteering can be a perfect fit for the kind of entertainer who, like Paul Mesner concedes, might at times have a few control issues. But even then, characters made from cloth and wood can't always be counted on to cooperate fully.
Oh, they grab onto something backstage and you're trying to get your hand in it or pick the puppet up to take it on stage and it's this tangled mess. Thankfully, I perform live and so you just rewrite some of the script real quick and as long as you remember this is the character speaking, the character can say, oh, I've got a problem.
I'm hung up back here.
You know, whatever. And the audience actually likes that. The audience loves to see you struggle a little bit, and when you succeed, you're a hero. All these artifacts sit around from various shows. This is the moon from the Mikado, the opera we did. Here we have the little squirrel that pops up out of the tree. That's from Best Pet of All. Whale frame from Just So Stories. This was is the main cat from Old Mother Hubbard.
25 years of Kansas City shows leaves behind lots of evidence, much of which is stored amazingly efficiently in the Mesner complex at Linwood and Harrison, for now at least, the operation's home base.
Years ago, I discovered I was no good at scene painting. So almost from the very beginning, I've been hiring scenic artists. I was okay at sewing, but now and then, in the early years, I'd rope my mother into sewing. And in later years, I would hire someone who'd help make the puppets because I got to be the point where I was performing so much. And then the work grew and then I needed someone else to go do a show sometimes. And I started wanting to make the shows bigger. Instead of just one person, I put two or three in the cast.
The result, a full-fledged puppet company, putting full and part-time players to work. Among them, Mike Horner. He met Mesner in the second grade when the puppeteer came for a workshop at his elementary school.
When I do a show and come out afterwards and people say, oh, are you Paul Mesner? I say, well, no. Oh, does he still do shows? Oh, yes, yes, he's out, you know, performing in Seattle or Las Vegas or wherever. People are really surprised that, you know, it's grown so much beyond just Paul.
And grown with a lively mix of old, new, and recycled. From spiders, giants, pigs, and wolves, to current crowd pleasers like the Stinky Cheese Man.
We're doing a lot more contemporary children's literature. We want to find material that schools are interested in. Schools are still an important part of our business plan. But you also want to find material that reflects our tastes, and that hits the right note between irreverence and the lesson plan.
People don't realize how much we do and what we do in the community. Like with the temple, you know, we didn't know what we were quite getting into.
You heard right, the temple. This marks the third year that Paul's puppets have played an interactive role during the High Holy Days at Temple B'nai Yehuda in Overland Park. As with nativity plays he's done before, this kind of theatrical experience can be an eye-opener for all involved.
Just say each word's like...
The collaboration isn't just in the work, it's getting to know other people's work environments or their culture.
I love the research, you know. If our budgets were bigger, I might spend a lot more time on research. I love to know and understand what it is that we're doing. So many stories go back way farther than we think. I love to look at the weird little details that have been lost over the years. And the more arcane sometimes, the more fun, too.
And speaking of fun, did someone say Puppet Slam? This Friday night, No Kids Allowed crowd is pouring in for another idea whose time may have come. A puppet show aimed squarely at grown-ups. Not exactly X-rated, but not all of it PBS-friendly either.
I don't know the number, but there's 60 or 70 Puppet Slams nationwide, happening in cities all over. Portland, Seattle, Atlanta, New York has 3 or 4 of them. Puppeteers who've been, you know, always doing the kids' work, which is our bread and butter, and I love it, and I'm not going to turn my back on that. But it is sometimes very satisfying to talk to adults.
Paul's also talking to adults a lot lately about something else, a potential new home for the troupe here in Hyde Park. With plenty of space for staging bigger productions, teaching more classes, and building on the lessons learned from their first 25 years.
Every couple of years, I'm surprised at how much better I am. If I watch an old video, I go, oh, look at that manipulation, it's terrible. So I've definitely gotten better. And so I try and show the people I'm working with that this is how I do it now. And they don't have to wait 20 years to get better.
There was one point this past year where Paul was in Seattle, I was in St. Louis, and then Gabby and another puppeteer were here doing a show. And there's not many other puppet companies in the country that could do that.
And you can learn more about Puppet Slams and the new season of shows for younger audiences at paulmesnerpuppets.org.